It is primary eve in what is for now the center of the political universe, New Hampshire. Political director Lisa Desjardins is in the Granite State as she kicks off our coverage of the high-stakes sprint to the finish.
Thanks. Good to see you guys.
They were in Manchester chatting with diners.
Let me tell you, sir, you know.
And in Plastow taking questions from veterans. Republicans and Democrats, favorites and long shots, nearly all the candidates were going all out, seeking out undecideds and trying to turn their rivals' supporters into their own. For Republican Marco Rubio, that meant shaking off criticism that he came off as canned in Saturday night's debate and pressing his message at a town hall in Nashua.
People keep, there's in the press anyway, oh, why do you keep saying the same thing about Obama trying to change America? I'm going to keep saying that a million times because I believe it's true.
Hey, how you doing, baby?
For Chris Christie, Rubio's dogged debate night foe, it meant keeping the heat on the Florida senator at a town hall of his own in nearby Hudson.
When the lights get that bright, you either shine or you melt. We cannot afford to have a president who melts.
And for Jeb Bush, Rubio's one-time mentor turned rival, it meant taking up his own line of attack this morning on MSNBC.
He doesn't have a record.
So
that's not to say he's not gifted, because he is. He's a gifted person, and he will be a leader going forward, but he doesn't have a proven record.
Bush's campaign also put up an ad today hitting at another of his rivals, John Kasich.
The Cato Institute gave you a D on its government's report card this last year.
But Kasich, at a town hall in Plastow, stood by his record on budget issues as Ohio governor.
We were way in the hole, now we're way in the black.
You did wonderful last night.
Thank you very much. Yeah, it was good.
In the meantime, the Republican frontrunner here, Donald Trump, has switched tactics after his runner-up finish in Iowa. He tried his hand at retail politics in Salem instead of holding one of his signature rallies.
I love these things even more than making a speech, because I love to hear the feedback. I get some good questions.
And on the Democratic side,
join with us in making that political revolution. Thank you all very much.
Next door neighbor and Vermont Senator Bernie Sanders pressed his apparent advantage in the polls in New Hampshire. He also drew ever sharper attacks from Hillary Clinton's camp. Last night in Milford, it was former President Bill Clinton.
For her, this is not about grand theories of revolution. This is about whether we can improve people's lives.
The former chief executive went further, accusing Sanders supporters of profane and sexist attacks on his wife. And on Saturday, former Secretary of State Madeleine Albright chastised women voters who backed Sanders instead of Clinton.
Just remember, there's a special place in hell for women who don't help each other.
Feminist icon Gloria Steinem went even further on HBO's Real Time with Bill Maher. She explained Clinton's lagging support among young women by saying, quote, when you're young, you're thinking, where are the boys? The boys are with Bernie. Steinem later apologized in a Facebook post. The candidate herself steered clear of all that fracas and stuck to a more traditional appeal in Manchester.
Imagine that finally women not only get equal pay, but our rights to make our own decisions are finally respected.
Of course, with 24 hours yet to go, some voters here already have gotten all the politics they can handle.
I will just be really glad when the primary is over. I am up to here with the ads on TV, and you can't get away from it.
But some candidates may get away from it for good after tomorrow, forced out of the race if they finish out of the money.
And, you know, late tonight, several candidates have sent out somewhat typical last-minute requests for funding, but that includes some like Carly Fiorina, who are needing a change in momentum. It seems certain that both Democrats running for president will survive New Hampshire, but it looks like of the nine Republicans running for president, no one expects all nine will still be running on Friday. From a snowy New Hampshire, Judy, back to you.
Lisa Desjardins, we thank you.